The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 26 through 29, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 30th, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
तथापि तं महाबाह नैनं सोचितं मारहस सो दिस इज द ओपिनियन ऑफ द मॉडर्न साइंटिस्ट और द बुद्ध फिलोसॉफी द सोल. There is nothing like soul separately, but by combination of matter at a certain state, the living symptoms are manifest. And as it is combination of several chemicals, so it is also finished. As soon as the body is finished, there is nothing as soul. That is your opinion. So, for argument's sake, Krishna says, if you think like that, that the body is all in all, by certain condition, the material elements combine, and again it is finished. So Arjuna was declining to fight, so they, for argument sake, Krishna says that if you think like that, the body is everything, so it will be destroyed automatically, so why you are so much afraid? Suppose I have combined some chemical and it is destroyed, the bottles of chemicals, somewhere or other it is destroyed. So who laments for that? You can purchase another bottle. That is simply for argument's sake. Actually, that is not the position. Now, if you think that the combination of chemical can produce living force, so why don't you do it in the laboratory? The chemicals are there. You can combine and just produce a small ant moving. Then it is. Science means observation and experiment. So if you simply observe and cannot make any experiment practical, so, then that is not science. That is only theory. So that is not possible. No scientist has ever made any living entity by combination of chemicals in the laboratory. Nobody can do that. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu ध्रुवं जन्म मृतस्य च तस्मात् अपरिहार्यार्थे न तं सूचितम् अर्हसि. जातस्य हि ध्रुवो मृत्यु. इट इज अ फैक्ट दैट बाय द साइकल ऑफ बर्थ एंड डेथ, वन हु डाइज ही हैज टू एक्सेप्ट अगेन अनदर बॉडी. So why you are deviating from your duty? The warfare of the Kshatriyas and the warfare at the present moment of the whimsical politicians, they are different. Formerly it was not democracy. Only the Kshatriyas would fight, especially the king, the royal order. they should come forward. Not that the politicians are sitting very comfortably at home and poor people, they are given to fight in front of the enemy. No, that was not the system. The king must come forward. The other side, the king also come, and the opposite side, he also should come forward and fight. It is duty, and as soon as the king is killed by the other party, then the other party becomes victorious. There is no more fight. It is not the so-called king and president is sitting very comfortably, and the poor soldiers are fighting unlimitedly, and the war is going on for many years. Just like last war, we saw at least 8 years it continued. 8 years, 6 years, no. The battle of Kurukshetra, it was finished within 18 days. There is no use of prolonging the war unnecessarily. If the chief man is killed, then war is finished. Therefore, Krishna is advising Arjuna, suppose your grandfather on the other side dies, so where is the cause of lamentation? He is old man. He will get another new body. So you should be rather happy that your old grandfather is going to have a new body. Jatasahi, Dhruvamattu, and everyone will die. You die today or tomorrow or say 50 years after. You have to die. It is as sure as death. So why should you deviate from your duty? You are a Kshatriya. Your duty is to fight. Why you are afraid of being dead or killing others? This is your duty. Abhaktadini bhutani bhaktam adhyani bharata abhaktam nidhanam aneva tatra kapurivedana. So, the body was not existing before, and it will not exist after death. So, in the Bhaya Media, if the manifestation of body is there, so why should be the object of lamentation? In this way, Krishna is trying to convince Arjuna that he should act as Kshatriya and perform his duty. A Kshatriya is profited either dead or alive. That will be explained. Because in a religious fighting, on principle, a Kshatriya is not responsible for killing. Just like in sacrifice or ceremony, if the animal is killed, the Brahman is not responsible for killing an animal. So, because it is duty, it is ordained by the Shastras, therefore, they are not ordinary killing. Abhaktyani and Nidhanani eva tatraka aparivat. It was non-manifested before, and it will become non-manifested again. So, why should you lament for the Bhaya Media? Āścajavat paśyati kaścit enam āścajavat vadati tathaiva chānya āścajavat cenam anya srinoti suttāpi enam veda na caiva kaścit. There are many theories and philosophical speculations all over the world about understanding the soul. Therefore, Krishna is concluding that somebody is explaining wonderfully, somebody is hearing wonderfully, but even after hearing and speaking, it remains a mystery, and less intelligent person cannot understand. That is the fact. There are so many theories. Therefore, we have to accept the reality from the authority. By theorizing, by speculating, we cannot come into any decision. I may be very good logician, you may be greater logician. So you can defeat my logic, I can defeat your logic. So what is the conclusion? This kind of talking, it is called kutarka, unnecessary talking. Because you will not come to my decision, I will not come to your decision. So everyone is mysterious. So in this way, we cannot understand which is beyond the perception of our knowledge. Achinta khaluje bhava natas tarkena juje. Things which are beyond our perception, we should not simply try to understand by logic and argument. It is useless, waste of time. Because nobody can decide theory. The modern so-called scientists, they also write that. Perhaps it may be right. It may be millions of years it was like this. It may be. What is the value of saying it may be? Say definitely. That they cannot do. All the scientists' theory, like perhaps, maybe, perchance, if it comes to be true. So such kind of argument has no value. Therefore, our Shastra says, Achinta khalijo bhava, beyond your perception, beyond your sense perception. Don't try to understand it by argument and logic. Then how to know it? Know it from the person who knows it. That is knowledge. That's why we are trying to get knowledge about the soul, not by experiment, but we are trying to understand from the words of Krishna. Krishna is the authority. So he says in the beginning, Dehinasmin jatha dehi kaumara jomanangara. We can, Krishna says, and we can think over it and ponder over it, then we come to conclusion. And the other process, Vedic process is, jasya devi parabhakti jatha devi tatha guru. Tasyaite katita jhatta prakashanti maha. Our process is descending process. We are not trying to understand by the ascending process, inductive or deductive. We accept the statements of the Veda. Therefore, we haven't got to make much effort to understand anything. Veda-vacham. Shruti, Shruti Prabhana. There are three kinds of evidences, direct perception and evidence from the Vedas and evidence from history, Aitijya. Pratyaksha, Aitijya, Shruti. Three kinds of evidences. So Pratyaksha and Aitijya is neglected. According to our Vedic system, Shruti Pramana. If it is statement, the statement is there in the Shruti, in the Vedas, then we accept. We have got a society in India. They call Veda Pramana. We cannot accept without it is not mentioned in the Vedas. That's nice. But there is another class who are described in the Bhagavad Gita by Krishna himself, Veda Badarata. They are simply, unnecessarily fight on the basis of so-called Vedic knowledge. Vedic knowledge must be understood from the Guru. That is in it. They defy that. The Vedic injunction is Kathopanishad. Tadvijnanatham sa gurumeva avigacchet. To understand the Vedas, you must approach a guru. Otherwise you cannot understand. just like it is forbidden that without becoming a brahmana, nobody should read Veda, because he cannot understand unless one is qualified brahman, unless one has approached another qualified brahman who knows. There is no question of understanding Veda. Just like Max Muller translated Veda. What does he know about Veda? Such kinds of translation, understanding is useless. Tadvijnanartham sa guru meva abhigacchet. Abhigacchet means he must. There is not that I may go or I may not. No, you must. If you really serious. In our Vaishnava parampara also, Vaishnava parampara is actually Vedic parampara. Adu Gudbhasram. Adu Gudbhasram. To enter into the spiritual life, first thing is, first of all, to accept a guru. That all big stalwarts, even Vyasadeva, the wonderful literature, this reading, we are reading Bhagavad Gita, it is Vyasadeva literature. He heard from Krishna and wrote it. And not only this, the Mahabharata, the Puranas, the Vedanta Sutra, Bhagavatam, wonderful literature. There is no possibility of producing such literature by any scholar of this day. It is not possible. But he accepted Guru, Narada. Narada, when after compiling all the Vedas and Puranas, even Vedanta Sutra, Vyasadeva was not satisfied himself. He was seeming very morose. At that time, his spiritual master Narada came. And he asked, why you are morose? You have done so much nice literary work. So why you are not very happy? So Vyasadeva replied, yes, my lord, I am actually not happy, but I cannot understand why I am not happy. So, you know everything, kindly describe why I am not happy. So at that time, Narada replied him that all the literatures you have so far made, they are with reference to the body and the mind. You have nothing described very nicely about the Supreme Soul. So now you try to describe something about the Supreme Lord, about the Supreme Soul. That will make you happy. And therefore, he described the Srimad Bhagavata. This is the history of Srimad Bhagavata. And his last contribution was, mature contribution, was Vedanta Sutra. So, from the Vedanta Sutra, he began writing Srimad Bhagavata, Janmadasya Jataha. This is the beginning of Vedanta Sutra, Athata Brahma Jignyasa. He said in the refined language, Jiva Satatta Jignyasa. So a human life should be engaged, inquiring about the absolute truth. And he should inquire from a person who has heard about the absolute truth from a realized person. This is a history, therefore it is called Shruti, Parampara, disciplic succession. One, just like Vyasadeva is hearing from Narada. Narada is authorized. He has heard from Brahma. Brahma has heard from Krishna. This is the Parampara system, disciplic succession. So, there are four parampara systems. They are known at the present moment, Ramanuja Sampradaya, Madhya Sampradaya. Brahma Sampradaya, Madhya Sampradaya is same. And Rudra Sampradaya and Sri Samaravana, Kumara Sampradaya. There is four sampradayas. So we should hear from the Sampradaya Acharya by disciplic succession, as Krishna recommends in this Bhagavad Gita. Evam parampara praptam imam rajasayo vidu. Imam vivasati yugam prattvana hamabhayam vivasana manave praho manu ikha kave praveed. Evam parampara praptam imam rajasayo vidu. So that is the system. We should receive knowledge by the bona fide parampara system. Otherwise, it may be bogus. Because without parampara system, we cannot understand actual fact. And we have to become in the disciplic succession. We must accept a guru. Tasmād gurum prapaddeta jigyāsu sreya uttamam. If you are actually eager, answer to understand the spiritual science, then you must approach a guru. Tasmād gurum prapaddeta jigyāsu sreya uttamam. Uttam means transcendental subject matter. You cannot learn it. Just like if you purchase one pharmacology book from the bookseller's shop, and if you read at home, do you mean that you become a medical practitioner, pharmacist? No. You must go to the university, you must go to the college, you must hear the experienced professor and learn it and practically experiment it. Then you can learn. And not that by purchasing a book you become a medical practitioner and a lawyer. That is not possible. Therefore the direction is that tad-vijñānārtham sa guru-meva avigacchet. But here also you see Krishna in the beginning was talking with Arjuna just like friends. But when Arjuna understood it, that we are talking like friends, so we cannot come into conclusion. The friends, they talk, they argue, they put logic. That way we cannot understand. Natastarkena jujya. Then, tadvijñānārtham sa guru meva avigacchet. So therefore, Arjuna surrendered himself. Sishasneham sarimam prapanna. Tatpanna dosu apahata sabhava. I can understand that I am a kshatriya. It is my duty to fight. But in front of my grandfather and relatives, I am declining to fight. Therefore, I am affected with tarpanna dosha. I am deviating from my duty. So, why I am deviating from this duty? Therefore, I am surrendering myself unto you. So, in a position of perplexity, one must approach a bona fide spiritual master. That is the process, basic process. Otherwise, it is not possible. And our Sanatana Goswami, a predecessor, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's direct disciple, he gives his direction that avaiṣṇava mukhat gīrna pūta hari kathāmṛtam sabanam na kattabvam. He says, do not hear from a person who is not a Vaiṣṇava. One must become a Vaiṣṇava. Otherwise, his so-called ideas and interpretation has no value. Has no value. Just like in your country, South India, Dr. Radhakrishna, he has done so many work. To tell you frankly, it is useless labor. Because he has said in one of his writings that Bhagavad Gita is mental speculation. He is surpassing all the acharyas who appeared in South India. Ramanacharya appeared in South India. Madhyacharya appeared in South India. Nimbarka appeared in South India. Vishnu Swami appeared in South India. Shankaracharya appeared in South India. The South India is so blessed. And he also appeared in South India. He is decrying all the others. Let's see the position. He says, Bhagavad Gita is a mental speculation. And he has interpreted in a different way. Krishna says that Manmanam Ahamad Bhakta Madhyadi Mang Namaskuru. And if you have seen Dr. Radhakrishna's translation of Bhagavad Gita, he says it is not to Krishna. Krishna says directly that Manmanam Ahamad Bhakta, he says not to Krishna. This defect will be there unless one is Sadatar Sampanna Vaishnava, self-realized. Therefore, Sanatana Goswami says, Avaishnava Mukhadgina Puta Hari Kathamritam. Our first guru is Krishna. To understand Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna is understanding Bhagavad Gita from Krishna directly. So, after understanding Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna accepts Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. Parabrahma, Paramdhama, Pavitram, Paramam Bhava, Purusam, Shastatam, Adhyam. These are the words. And Arjuna also accepted, it is very, very difficult to understand your personality. Now, people may say that Arjuna was Krishna's friend. To satisfy his friend, he has accepted him as Parabrahma. But that is not the fact. Arjuna gives evidences that not only I, but the great authorities like Vyasa, Narada, Asita, Devala, they have also accepted you as the Supreme Personality of God. In the recent ages, this is 5,000 years ago, even 1,500, Shankaracharya, who is impersonal, he has also accepted Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. So Bhagavan Swayam Krishna, he has written in his commentary on the Bhagavad Gita, Narayana Bhaktya Abbas, Parah Abbasya, Narayana Parah Abbasya. Narayana is not the creation of this material world. He is transcendental. He has accepted. And what to speak of the Vaishnava Acharyas, Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, all, they have written so many nice commentaries on the Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Sutra, establishing that the Supreme Absolute Truth is Person, the Supreme Personality of God. Krishna is speaking as Person, and he is warning the rascals, Abhijananti Manga Murha, Manasim Tanuvasita. Because I am speaking as a human being, the rascals, they derive Param Bhava Vajanam. They do not know what is my influence, what is my power. So, this personality of Godhead, it is a fact. Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavaneti Sabde. The last word is Bhagavan. From Bhagavan, the expansion is Paramatma, localized as Ishara Sarvabhutanav Riddhese Arjuna Tishtha. That is expansion. Ekanshena Situ. There is one of the plenary portion, Vishtabhya Aham. He enters within this universe, and therefore the universe becomes manifest. Just like I am soul, Dehi Nasmin Jatha Dehi. I enter into this body, you enter into your body, therefore the body expands. Similarly, the Supreme Personality of God enters as Garbhodok Sai Vishnu within each and every universe, then it becomes manifest. So, there is no question of impersonal. The original source is person. Krishna says, Aham sarvatsa prabhava, matta sarvam prabhata, iti matya bhajante mang buddha bhava sabandhi. Buddha, not the abuddha. Abuddha means less interesting. Those who are interior. Buddha, bhava samannita, with a bhava, with an ecstatic position can understand that Krishna is the original person. Aham sarvasvato. Sarvasva means including Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha, all the devotees. Aham adidhi divanam. He is the original source of all the devas. The original devas within this Brahma is the first deva, the first creation. So, aham adidhi divanam. The Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. So he is the origin of Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. From Krishna, for material creation, there are three Purusha. First of all, three Purusha. Not directly from Krishna. From Krishna, Baladev. From Baladev, Chaturbhuha, Sankarsan, Vasudeva Sankarsan, Pradyumna, Niruddha. Then from Sankarsan, Narayana. Then second Chaturbhuha. From the second Chaturbhuha, Sankarsan, the Purusha avatar. Three Purusha avatars, three Vishnus, Karana Dakshai, Garbho Dakshai, and Kiro Dakshai Vishnu. So, that in the Vedic literature, all these informations are there, and as Krishna says, personally also, Arjuna accepts, that I accept on the authority of Vyasdev, Narada, Devala, Asita, you are the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And you also speaking directly. Then where is my doubt? So we should follow. This is called parampara system. As Arjuna understood Bhagavad Gita, if we understand that way, then we are perfect. I may be imperfect, but because I understand Bhagavad Gita as it was understood by Arjuna, I am perfect. Because the knowledge I am distributing, that is not imperfect. Just like a post peon, his post peon is delivering you $1,000. Say he may be poor man, but the $1,000 he is delivering, that is a fact. That is not bogus. Because he has not manufactured something. He has received that money order from the post office. He is asked to deliver it to such and such person. His honesty is to deliver the money order as it is to the bona fide person. That is his perfection. He doesn't require, because he is delivering $1,000, he doesn't require to become a very rich man. He may be poor man. Similarly, A guru is perfect when he delivers the words of the superior authority as it is. Then he is perfect. He may be imperfect in your estimation, but that is his perfection. That he is not misleading people by becoming a so-called rascal scholar and interpreting in a different way and misleading the whole population. That is perfect. People say so much about me that I have done some wonderful thing. But I say that I am not a magician. I am not a magician. My only credit is that I am presenting Krishna as he is. That's all. I am not diluting Krishna. That is not my business. And therefore, because it is pure ghee, therefore everyone accepts. And if you place dalda, mixing with ghee, some rascal thing, then nobody will accept. Therefore, so many Samis went before me in the Western countries, and they presented adulterated. And there was not a single person became a Krishna bhakta. Now, by thousands they become. Why? Because it is presented pure thing. Your thing will be accepted, everyone. I give this example. In Delhi, there is confectioner's shop. He rigidly prepares in pure ghee all the sweetmeats. So you'll find always hundreds of customers there. and they are by the side of the Dalla manufacturer. It is not. People are still prepared to pay sufficiently if you give pure things. So, our this Krishna consciousness movement is presenting Bhagavad Gita as it. We have not manufactured anything. While I started this movement in America, some friends suggested that you are writing International Society for Krishna Consciousness. Why not make it God Consciousness? It will be accepted by everyone. No. God is Krishna. That must be clearly stated, Krishna Consciousness. I don't mind if nobody accepts it, but that must be Krishna. So, actually, it is very happy that Western countries, they are accepting Krishna. Why not? Krishna is for everyone. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He says, Aham Bija Padapita, Sarva Jonishu Kaunti. In all forms of life, the living entities, they are my part and parcel, they are my sons. I am the father, original. Bija Padapita. So why Krishna will not be accepted? And actually that is happening. They are coming from different groups. But because every one of us is Krishna's son, Krishna's part and parcel, therefore, simply it requires a little attentive hearing about Krishna. Sovanadi suddha chitte karoye udo. Teman mukhi hi jivhado samaiva surattada. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita it is said, Sravanadi suddha chitte karoye udo. Krishna is there in everyone's heart. Ishara Sarvabhutana. But we do not know. But Krishna and Krishna consciousness can be awakened simply by hearing from the realized path. Satang prasangad mama bija sangita bhavanti ritkanna rasayana katha. Satang prasanga from the lips of devotee. When it is heard, then it becomes ritkanna rasayana. It becomes very pleasing to the ear and to the heart. Tadjosanat, if one cultivates in that way, asu abhavarga batmane, saddha bhakti rati ranukramishyati. These are the formulas. So, the process should be to receive the knowledge by disciplic success, not sporadically hearing sometimes this scholar, hearing something this scholar. I interpret in my scholarship. No, this thing is not. Our process is as directed by Sanatana Goswami. Avaishnava mukhat gina puta hari katha amrita. Hari katha is amrita. Amrita. But still, it should not be received when it is uttered by some avaishnava. There is another direction. Avaishnava guru na sasyat. Satkarma nipuna vipra mantra tantra visharana. A person, a brahman, satkarma nipuna. Brahmana's business is to become scholar and to make other scholars, pathana pathana, jajana jajana. He must be a worshipper and he must teach others how to worship. Pathana pathana jajana jajana. Dana pratijyaha. Brahmana receive charity and he makes immediately distribute the charity. So these are the occupational duty of Brahman. Pathan path, satkarma. Satkarma nipuna. A Brahman, he is very expert in his business. Satkarma. Satkarma nipuna. Mantra tantra visharata. And he has read the Vedic literatures and tantras very nicely. Visharata. Still, if he is not a Vaishnava, the avaishnava, guru na sasya. So by that only qualification that he is not a Vaishnava, he cannot become Guru. Whereas on the other hand, Sad Vaishnava Sapata Guru, if a person sapata means coming of the family of dog eater, chandal, if he has become a Vaishnava, Sadatar Sampanna Vaishnava, so Guru Sad, you can accept him as Guru. There are so many instances. He was Ramanujacharya's guru, was not from a Brahmin family, but still he accepted guru. So, in the Vaishnava literature, just like Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur, we gave jai, Thakur Haridas Thakur ki jai, we say. This Haridas Thakur was born in a Mohammedan family. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made him Namacharya, Srila Haridas Thakur. He was chanting Hare Krishna mantra daily, 300,000 of times. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu selected him, Namacharya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself came to broadcast the glory of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So instead of becoming himself the Acharya, he designated Haridas Thakur as Acharya. Similarly, Sri Sanatana Goswami, Sri Rupa Goswami, they also became Mahavira. They were born in Hindu Saraswat Brahman family. But due to their association as minister of the then Muslim government, they were rejected from the Brahman society. Formerly the Brahman society was very strict. Anyone becoming servant, is immediately excluded. So you cannot become a Brahmin. You are serving. In the Srimad Bhagavatam also, spoken by Narada, he says, a Brahmana, if he is in difficulty, he should not accept the business of a dog, service. He should not accept service. He may go to the profession of a Kshatriya, or even up to Vaishya, not of a Shudra. These are the injunctions. So they were strictly being followed. These Sanatana Goswami, they are very learned scholars in Sanskrit, in Arabic language, Persian language. But because they accepted the ministership of Nawab Hussain Shah, immediately they were rejected. And they changed their name. Almost they became Muslim. Thakur Malik Davir Khas, their name was that. These are Mohammedan names. So they were living like that. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu blessed them, they became the first class Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. And he therefore said, Prithivite Ase Jato Navaradigya. He asked to spread his Krishna consciousness movement all over the world, in every village, in every town. Does he mean that let them become Shudras, let them remain Shudras, and they become Krishna conscious? No. He did not mean like that. That means everywhere there should be Vaishnava. And a Vaishnava means above Brahman. That is the Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Because you are here, it is for you. For us, you means you, me. Because we wanted to enjoy, we wanted to lord it over the material nature. Therefore, God has given you the facility that you enjoy. But just to make you convinced that we cannot enjoy, we become enjoyed. This conviction, when you come to this conviction that we cannot enjoy, we become enjoyed. At that time, we seek after God. That is natural. Athāta brahma jignāt. So, God has created this material world because we wanted it. That is it, philosophy. But they, now, the trouble must be there, because God has created this world for your enjoyment and for my enjoyment. They therefore must be struggle, because I don't agree with you, you don't agree with me. So why there's a lot of trouble? Because if everyone, just like in an office, if everyone wants to become the proprietor, will not there be confusion and chaos? Do you think the office will go on nicely? Similarly, here, God has given you a chance to become master because you want it. But everyone wants to be master, and there is chaos. How there can be harmony when everyone wants to become God? Do you think it is all right? There must be chaos. Here is the position. Everyone in the material world, first of all, they want to become a big man, big businessman, big this, big that, minister, president. And when everything is failure, then he wants to become God. That is the last snare of Maya. So, this is going on. How you can expect peace and prosperity here? That is not possible. Dukkhalayam asasatam. It is stated by Krishna himself that this is a place only for misery. But under the influence of Maya, we are accepting all miserable conditions of life as happiness. This is called Maya. He is qualified. Satta, Thama, Dhamma, Titikha, Arjava, Astikam, Jnanam, Vijnanam. When one has acquired all these qualities, then he becomes Brahman. Kanta Krishna Kanta. Sagunan samapitta itan brahma bhuyaya kalpat. Manchabhya vicharini bhakti yogi na jasiva. Unless we come to that platform of bhakti yoga and become re-related, not related, again, revive our Krishna consciousness, there cannot be equality. That is not possible. There must be distinction, some higher class, some middle class, some lower class. Even in European countries, there in America, there are so are in India. So it is not very astonishing, because the whole world is being conducted, the whole material nature is being conducted by the three gunas, and anyone associating with a particular type of guna, he must suffer and enjoy according to that guna. Jaganna guna vrittista adho vatshanti tamasa. Tamasa. Those who are in the tamasic zone, they go adha. Madde tisthanti rajasa. And bhayamidya, those who are in touch with the rajaguna. And urdhanga chanti sattasva. Those who are in the goodness, they go up in the upper platform of the society or in the universe. But Krishna says, abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravastinte. Either you go even to the brahma loka. One day you have to come to the hellish loka. This is the way. Chakravat parivartanti sukhani dukhani. Just like the wheel. Turns down, sometimes up, sometimes down. So, this is the position of this material world. There is no question of lamenting. You cannot say, these people are suffering and that people are enjoying. The man who is enjoying, he will also suffer next moment. This is going on, suffering and enjoying. Unless we come to Krishna consciousness, there is no way of coming out of these duality of this world. This is duality. Everything you will find in dual. Unless there is happiness, you cannot understand what is distress. And unless there is distress, you cannot understand happiness. You cannot understand light unless there is darkness. So this is the world of darkness and light, so-called light. You have to transcend. Saptadi hang punarjanmanaiti. So, we have to make arrangement. That facility is there to every human being. How he can get out of this world of duality and come to the transcendental platform, which is called Abhyavicharini Bhakti Yoga. Mancha Abhyavicharini Bhakti Yogi Naja Sevate sagunan samasitta itan brahma bhuyaya kalpa. That is the question. Chant Hare Krishna. Thank you. What is that? So you reject everything, that's all. That is the way. That is very nice for us. You reject everything. Because you have doubt in everything, so you reject everything. That's all. Therefore, our philosophy is Achinta Vidaveta. Achinta, inconscient. That's where you are trying to conceive that whole world is God, and still God is not there. That is spoken by God Himself, Krishna. Masthani sarvabhutani nahang tesu avasthita maya tatamidam abhakta murtina. So, this impersonal feature, brahmeti, paramatmeti, bhagavaniti, the impersonal feature is Brahma. Sarvam khaluidam Brahma. That means, sarvedam akhilam jagat. Paratsa brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. It's like the sunshine. You are in the sunshine. There is a practical thing. The sunshine is not different from the sun. The sun is 93 millions of miles away. But still, because you are in the sunshine, you are in sun. Can you deny it? That is the thing. You are in the sunshine. The sunshine is not different from the sun, but still it is not the sun. This is the philosophy. Inconceivably, simultaneously, one and different. The sunshine is not different from the sun, but still it is different. Similarly, the whole manifested, the cosmic manifestation is God, but still it is not God. This is therefore it is called inconceivable, achinta. With our teeny brain, we cannot accommodate how it is one and different.